In February, Chinese scientist Tan Hongjin was sentenced to 2 years in prison by the Federal Court of Oklahoma for allegedly stealing trade secrets worth $1 billion from his employer. In compensation, he was forced to pay his employer $150,000 and will face deportation after release. So how did Tan steal from his employer? How did he get caught? And who was behind this? On May 27th, the FBI published further details about this case. Let's find out. So who exactly is Tan Hongjin? Tan Hongjin is a Chinese citizen living as a permanent resident in the United States. According to his LinkedIn profile, he earned his bachelor's degree from Nanjing University, one of China's top universities. In 2006, he went to Caltech to complete his master's degree and PhD. Then he took different jobs in California until June 2017, when he moved to Bartlesville, Oklahoma to work in a research center operated by Phillips 66, an energy company headquartered in Houston, Texas. There, Tan worked on a team responsible for developing next-generation technologies for lithium-based battery systems. Suspicious resignation. After 18 months at Phillips 66, Tan Hongjin handed in his resignation. The reason he gave his supervisor was he needed to go back to China to take care of his parents. He planned to leave on the 29th. As he claimed to not be looking for employment elsewhere, his supervisor allowed him to stay on the job until the departure date in December, instead of letting him go immediately. Tan Hongjin's plan would have worked had he chosen to leave right away or known how to keep a secret. Unfortunately, he did neither of those things. At dinner with a colleague, he revealed that he actually had a job waiting for him in China. If you have ever seen a James Bond movie, you know the villain explaining his plan to anyone never works out in the villain's favor. The company he was going to work for was Xiamen Tungsten, a state-controlled company whose main business is the smelting and processing of metal products. It is also a provider of lithium battery materials. Because that was contrary to what he told his employer, the colleague reported their conversation to a supervisor. Again, if you have an evil plan to steal billions of dollars, the less people you tell, the better. The thumb drive. Figuring that Tan Hongjin had questionable motives, because, well, he basically told them he had questionable motives, the company terminated his employment immediately and began investigating records of his access to company documents and systems. They found that Tan had been accessing sensitive information related to the technologies he wasn't assigned to work on. On December 13th, the company reported Tan and his suspected crime to the FBI. Likely aware of the investigation, Tan just kept digging the hole he was in deeper and deeper. He called his supervisor and admitted to having a thumb drive that contained company documents and tried to explain his motives. FBI Special Agent Jeremy Sykes stated, he said he was hoping to read them to continue his research work. And quote, the company told him he needed to return the thumb drive. When he brought back the thumb drive, the firm looked at the slack space on the drive and found several files had been erased, said Sykes. The deleted files were the files the company was the most concerned about. With the company and the FBI working together, Tan Hongjin was arrested before he could leave the U.S. So what exactly did Tan steal, and what was its value? Billion-dollar trade secret. Phillips 66 had spent decades developing a technology primarily for next-generation batteries. The technology could also be used for melting metals, which is believed to be even more valuable than its primary application. Apparently, this technology could be very useful to Xiamen Tungsten, Tan Hongjin's next employer. The FBI estimated what Tan Hongjin stole to be worth $1 billion. As Special Agent Rebecca Day put it, if you got your hands on this information, you would be decades ahead of where you would have started out on this technology. We won't tolerate people who come into the United States to steal for the betterment of a foreign government or foreign company. So who is behind Tan Hongjin's trade secret theft? The Thousand Talents Plan. As revealed by the FBI, Tan Hongjin started to access Phillips 66's sensitive documents around the time he applied for the Chinese Communist Party's Thousand Talents Plan. Is this one of those talents tap dancing? Because if so, sadly, I'm still not in it. Since the timing of him accessing the documents largely matches his trips to China, and the last time he did it was the day before his resignation. As the Department of Justice stated, quote, these talents programs seek to lure Chinese overseas talent and foreign experts to bring their knowledge and experience to China and reward individuals for stealing proprietary information. A U.S. Senate investigation found that the CCP has recruited over 7,000 professionals, including Nobel laureates. Perhaps the most famous participant was the former Harvard professor Dr. Charles Lieber, who is now facing 5 years in prison and a $250,000 fine. The Thousand Talents Plan is perceived by the CCP as a shortcut to achieve technological dominance. FBI Director Christopher Wray described it, quote, "We see Chinese companies stealing American intellectual property to avoid the hard slog of innovation, and then using it to compete against the very American companies they victimized. In effect, cheating twice over." Tan Hongjin is only one of the many encouraged by the CCP to obtain critical technologies from the West through theft and deceit. Now he has got what he deserved. But when will the CCP pay the price? Leave your comments below. Thank you for watching Unseen Fortunes. If you enjoyed our content, please click like, subscribe, and share. We'll see you next time.